remember is how cold it was that day in November. I had lived in an industrial nightmare of concrete and barbed wire. I remembered the man whose dark gaze had reached down into my soul. I heard him call my name. I played for the girl who lived downstairs from me. The pressure had gotten to her. All that was left of her.
Your son is only 16. He goes to school, gets good grades. He's gonna be a piano player. He's talented.
I played for my parents, who constantly fought over me. I had went to the barbershop that day. Lucky was there.
Fuck out my face before I smack the shit out.
He was a former honor student at Holmes Academy. Now he's a full-time drug dealer.
Money make the world go round, son. Just be like that. Why don't you go and clean me up, T? What, you thought that was fucked up? Huh? Motherfucker, I'm talking to you. Suck your teeth to me again, boy. I dare you.
Whenever I was away from my piano, all the pain I felt caught up to me.
You ain't gonna get shit in this world unless you stand up and take it. You heard me? Like this chair right here. You want the motherfucker, right? Right? Come take it from me. Little bitch ass nigga.
Lucky lived by his bullshit philosophy. And died by it. My heart was beating. I was paralyzed. I wanted to scream, but it was like I had no mouth. The last shot had killed Lucky. Brought me to a moment of clarity. And that's when I recognized him. It was the man from before. He looked at me. He was speaking to me mentally and told me not to be scared. He offered me a choice, a new way of living. All I had to do was take the money and leave behind my soul. That's when I had gone on a dark journey. I saw terrible things. And a possible future. I went home after the shooting. I felt tired, scared, and confused. The next day I played. My father had heard about the murder and told my mother. My mother told him I went to the barbershop. My father was worried. Till this day, I don't know if he was hearing me play. Although I had felt his presence behind me. I never did take the money. And I never saw him again. That was 12 years ago.